Good day, and welcome to the channel. This video looks at the much anticipated RPG Starfield and whether it will run on an integrated graphics setup. So that you know what kind of rig I'm testing on, here are the specs. An AMD Ryzen 9 6900HX processor paired to a Radeon 680M integrated GPU with 32GB of DDR5 RAM, 8 of which are dedicated as VRAM. To start the game, I didn't mess with the settings at all and just went into it at whatever the default setting was. Later I learned that I was playing on medium with AMD FSR2 upscaling enabled. At one point I noticed things were pretty pixelated. I went back into the settings and learned about the game's dynamic resolution setting. When turned on, it adjusts the game resolution on the fly to try and maintain a better frame rate. The downside being that if it reduces the frame rate too low, it's visibly obvious. The game felt pretty good on medium actually, so I knocked it up to high for a bit to check it out. It still felt not bad, which I attribute to the dynamic resolution. Moving the mouse around quickly though, the lag was noticeable. Since the game starts underground, without long draw distances and poor lighting, I thought I'd wait until I got to a brightly lit area for a better evaluation. I went into the character creator with the display settings still set to high. Again, everything looked pretty good, particularly considering the game was running on an integrated GPU, but sometimes the outline of the character model looked pixelated. Again, likely due to the dynamic resolution adjusting things a bit. Finally above ground, I didn't mind how things looked and felt. There was definitely some lag when I moved the mouse quickly, but the textures and models looked really good. I decided to move to the next phase of the test and enable the FPS counter and system monitoring tools. The FPS sat right around 15 frames per second, which seemed a little lower than how it felt, but is higher than it probably had any right to be. I knocked the settings down to medium and turned FSR off to see how the game looked on its own. Turning off FSR also disabled the dynamic resolution setting. Dropping to medium resulted in a small frame rate increase, bringing the FPS up to about 19 frames per second. I dropped the settings further to low, again with the FRS disabled. This brought the average frame rate up to the low 20s, and just in time for testing, a ship with some bad guys showed up. All of the character models in the same area, as well as the effects from the weapons, really did a number on the frame rate, dropping it down to just over 10 frames per second. At that point, I brought FSR2 and dynamic resolution back into play, with graphics set to medium. This bumped the frame rate up by 50% to the mid-teens, but the resolution was noticeably lowered, with AMD's FSR2 upscaling unable to polish the image enough to make it look good. Still, I was able to participate in combat and aim my gun at targets. Dropping the graphics setting to low didn't have much of an impact on frame rate, probably because the dynamic resolution was already lowering things pretty considerably while on medium. Going into space was quite good for the frame rate, hanging out in the mid-20s for the time that I was there. Overall, can Starfield run on a computer with integrated graphics? Well, yes, though with the caveat that it needs to be a newer chip with adequate memory. Any integrated GPUs more than about a year old are probably not going to be able to make it happen. Also, it depends on what level of graphic fidelity you're willing to accept. I plan on continuing to play it on my system, though with the hope that it finds its way to GeForce Now at some point. If your system is lower specs than mine and you really want to try it, buy the game on Steam. If it doesn't work out for you, you can take advantage of their great return policy and you've lost nothing. Thanks very much for watching, and if you found this video useful, hit the subscribe button.